Warm greetings to all of you. I am Dr. Neeraj Dilbagi, Professor of Nanobiotechnology and Director, UGC Human Resource Development Center, Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar. The title of this module is Innovative Ideas for 21st Century Education. Friends, as we know, the major thrust of pedagogy in 21st century is creation of self-directed learners and mobilized talents and hidden potential of each and every individual with ICT-supported pedagogical innovations. It is also debatable that how internet is transforming the way people live, work and earn. This is the need of our that we should rethink about education and educational experiences. The pedagogy of 21st century demands dynamic learners, not robots nor machines, who possess sensory awareness, creativity and social intelligence. 21st century education needs to develop human qualities along with happiness. This module highlights innovative ideas for 21st century education which help the teachers and policy makers to bring the desired outcome. After completing this module, the learners will be able to understand the concept of innovative ideas for 21st century education. The second outcome will be the diversity of innovative ideas for 21st century education. And also, the learners will understand the concept of building a 21st century classroom. Now, let us understand what is the concept of innovative ideas for 21st century education. The very objective of 21st century education is concerned with skill-based education, which is highly useful for a learner in succeeding and being confident in the world. Millennium century skills focus on analyzing, assessing information, and then creating and sharing this in a smart ways. The philosophy of this new pedagogy is based on providing multifaceted learning environment which has characteristics of authentic learning, personal development and life skills. We, the teachers, are just facilitators and producers of creative learning environment for 21st century classrooms, where students can develop their creativity, critical understanding, problem solving and collaborative skills. The 21st century classrooms are different from 20th century classrooms. The term 21st century skills consists of core competencies such as creativity, critical understanding, problem solving, digital competence and collaboration. It believes in education or institutions preparing and helping students to flourish in real life world. Now, let us understand some diverse innovative ideas from which 21st century education will grow and thrive. A common assumption about educational experiences is that a classroom where teacher prepares his lesson of 1 hour, where students should act as a silent perceptor with no more questioning, no mobiles, etc. For learning, a learner should come to the four walls of classroom. And for teaching, a teacher should come to the static classroom. But 21st century demands new innovations for preparing youth with skill education. Here are some innovative ideas for 21st century education to make the classroom and educational experience more friendly and exciting. The first idea is to expose lessons. That is, opening up the lessons means there should be no boundary for time limit, no military precision of executing the lesson in a specified manner within the four walls of classroom with static mindset, because one size does not fit all. A lesson can be delivered through many things. Of course, it must be structured within the content and curriculum framework. A teacher can extend or shorten the lesson in a manner that allows flexible style of teaching. Traditional way of teaching can be transformed with millennium teaching with the support of digital tools and technology. In teaching, one specific unit may be adopted like a blended, flipped classroom approach where information is transmitted through outside as well as classroom through online mode. The free up classroom time can now be utilized for fruitful discussions, interrogation, and practical application of the concept, and thus will maximize the productivity of higher learner outcome. When students have their personalized lesson and greater control on learning, they will learn more. The second idea is to think outside the classroom box. Collaboration, creativity, critical understanding, problem solving, digital literacy, information and economic literacy requires new teaching methods, new teaching styles in a dynamic and vibrant manner. The role of teacher is to guide, discuss, and assess the progress of student and give them more support along with transacting knowledge and information. A teacher should think outside the classroom box. Also, the student should have their open learning space where they are free to tackle complex problems and working where they decide they need to be. The third element is to get personal. Every learner has his own learning style, own multiple intelligence, and own learning speed. Digital tools may provide pace to the personalized learning from which teachers can prepare teaching material in a personalized way. Through this, they can keep track of students' progress all the time without spending much hours on manual marking. They may reflect a personal touch through digital tools, project-based learning, and passion-driven learning. The project-based learning offers more essential opportunities for personal learning space because it strengthens passion, interest, and skills among students. Students must be given opportunities for passion-driven learning by giving them half an hour of independent time at the start of the day to pursue whatever they are interested in using all resources available to them. The fourth idea is to tap students' digital expertise. An ideal teacher should tap digital expertise of the students. They may use this expertise very easily and comfortably because these technologies are handy to students. The utilization of these technologies may lead to support, independent, inquiry-based learning, collaborative project work. By introducing technology into educational experiences, learning may be faster, and tapping electronic gadgets for analyzing, assessing, and generating information at much speed, scale, and depth that no institution or any static library can match. A teacher may use smartphones by giving instant messages, blogs, email, and Twitter for building and cultivating strong relationships. By adopting BYOD policy or bring your own device policy, students may be allowed to use their mobiles and other gadgets in classrooms. It also encourages learners' engagements in their learning inside and outside the institution. The fifth component is get real with projects. Project works sharpen the multiple skills and demonstrate how to present the matter in front of public. From this activity, students gain manifold experience of working in teams, managing their own lives and all life skills. The project helps students in developing themselves into lifelong learner. So the bottom line is, give your students project work. The sixth idea is to expect help from students to be teacher. In some cases, it is found that students may support teacher by giving them ideas, advice, and often a listening ear to their friends and classmates. They often have a natural sense of what their peers find interesting. Some more responsibility and assignments may be given to students for peer group teaching. The next idea is, help teachers to be students. Pedagogy of 21st century stresses teachers to be resilient, independent, and flexible learners. Resilient learners are those learners who are able to learn from their mistakes, while independent learners are willing to take ownership of their learning. On the other hand, flexible learners are ready to use different learning strategies to navigate and adapt to a rapidly changing world. To be a good teacher, one has to first become a good learner and explore the vision of student by becoming a student. Mahatma Gandhiji encourages us to be the change that you wish to see in the world. If we may borrow these wise words from Gandhiji, how about be the change that we wish to see in the classroom? Another important factor is to measure what matters. Assessments are feedback and reflection of what has been taught, information of knowledge and skill. In digital age, the information is at our fingertips through internet. But the ability for analysis and synthesis is not up to the mark as it should be. Additionally, there are also soft skills which should be assessed properly. Teachers should know assessment strategies in very clear terms. Another innovative idea worth implementing is work with parents, not just learners. Many studies have shown that involvement and participation of participants is crucial in educational experiences. Thus, there is a need to work in partnership with other services that enable parents to access information and act as support. Strengthening the relationship between institutions, parents, and community enhance student engagements and academic achievements. If a university goes to community and a community comes to the university, this bond can yield fruitful results. This can be done through social networking. And the last one, but not the least, is power to the students. Students' voice or involvement is important in resolving issues, planning, decision making in their classroom and their institutions. So give power to the students in strategic decisions also. So these are some of the diverse innovative ideas for 21st century education.